Well, hello there, and welcome to Monster Monday. Today, we'll be talking about some undead, and that one is specifically the White. Well, the White has been around for all of D&D. Because it's one of those creatures that's adapted from folklore. And it's a good low to mid-level encounter. And it can be tied pretty well into longer-running campaigns that have recurring themes of dealing with the undead. So let's explore the White. The word white meant person in days of yore, but the name now refers to evil undead, who were once mortals driven by dark desire and great vanity. When death stills such a creature's heart and snuffs its living breath, its spirit cries out to the demon lord Orcus or some vile god of the underworld for a reprieve, undeath, in return for eternal war on the living. If a dark power answers the call, the spirit is granted undeath so that it can pursue its own malevolent agenda. Whites possess the memories and drives of their formerly living selves. They will heed the call of whatever dark entity transformed them into undead, swearing oaths to appease their new lord while retaining their autonomy. Never tiring, a white can pursue its goals relentlessly and without distraction. Life eaters. Neither dead nor alive, a white exists in a transitional state between one world and the next. The bright spark it possessed in life is gone, and in its place is a yearning to consume that spark in all living things. When a white attacks, the life essence glows like white-hot embers to its dark eyes, and the white's cold touch can drain the spark through flesh, clothing, and armor. Whites flee from the world by day, away from the light of the sun, which they hate. They retreat to burrow mounds, crypts, and tombs where they dwell. Their lairs are silent, desolate places surrounded by dead plants, noticeably blackened and avoided by bird and beast. Humanoids slain by a white can rise as zombies under its control, motivated by hunger for living souls and driven by the same desire for power that awakened them in undeath. Some whites serve as shock troops for evil leaders, including wraiths. As soldiers, they are able to plan but seldom do so, relying on their hunger for destruction to overwhelm any creature that stands before them. A white doesn't require air, food, drink, or sleep. So, a lot of cool ideas for how we can use a white. I could see this being scaled. Yes, indeed. Low level, mid, or high. So, white is a medium undead with an AC of 14, challenge rating 3. They have damage resistance to necrotic, bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing from non-magical attacks not made with silvered weapons. Damage immunities to poison, and condition immunities to being exhausted or poisoned. Dark vision of 60 feet. They have sunlight sensitivity. While in sunlight, the white has disadvantage on attack rolls as well as on wisdom perception checks that rely on sight. So in a lot of ways, the white is really a cool creature that you could drop in for encounters in the right settings. And I think those settings would include kind of ones that they were mentioned. Anytime you have, a party that's traveling, they could come across burial mounds or a cemetery, or if they're exploring ruins, or even in dungeons. I think there's a lot of different areas where a white could be encountered. Maybe there's like a haunted mansion outside of town, on the outskirts of town, and that's where this white resides. But I think that they could be used in conjunction, as this referenced, with a lot of cool things. So if you remember my video about the Bodak being a servant of Orcus, I could see whites being a good lead-up encounter to the Bodaks. So that's where I think the scalability really works well. They have multi-attacks, so they make two longsword attacks or two longbow attacks. It can use its life drain in place of one longsword attack. Life drain is a melee weapon attack, +4 to hit, 1d6 +2 necrotic damage. The target must succeed on a DC 13 con save, or its hit point maximum is reduced by an amount equal to the damage taken. This reduction lasts until the target finishes a long rest. The target dies if this effect reduces its hit point maximum to zero. A humanoid slain by this attack rises 24 hours later as a zombie under the white's control, unless the humanoid is restored to life or its body is destroyed. The white can have no more than 12 zombies under its control at one time. No more than 12. So it can walk around. One white could have 12 zombies. Save that nugget for a couple minutes from now. Its other attacks are the longsword attack, which is pretty basic. Same thing with the longbow, pretty standard. So the white is really cool, and you could use it most definitively at any level. So let's break it down. For your low-level encounters, one white is probably good enough to take on a low-level party and could seriously damage a low-level party. So use with caution. At mid-level, you could have one white and 12 zombies be a reasonable encounter with some mid-level people. Or if you feel like your mid-level party is on the higher end of the mid-level, you can have multiple whites with multiple zombies. Those using in conjunction to attack a force could work really well. At high levels, I think the whites serving as a attack force for a higher level creature could also work really well in conjunction with zombies, and you can even scale them up. One way that you could scale them up would be for the life drain attack, giving them like a DC that's higher, so maybe a DC of 16, and have the life drain do double the amount of necrotic damage. You can give the whites more hit points, you can give them a higher armor class, like put them in plate mail with a shield, and you know, all of a sudden they're scaled up so that they're a more reasonable foe for a high level party. Let's get to story. So as I referenced, I think this is a great bridge between other undead or for long running campaign arcs where you want to have the heroic party facing, you know, evil in its truest form. This could be, you know, the kind of referenced ideas that I mentioned in the Bodek encounters, where maybe there's mortal cults that you don't reveal are worshiping Orcus, but they're obviously evil, they're involved in some rituals, the party interrupts them and defeats their ritual, or, you know, destroys their temple. And now there's a white who's been sent forth to, you know, take on this party. And maybe the party defeats the white, or maybe the white is a mystery to the party at first. Maybe they come to this small village and there's like zombies, and you know, no one knows why these zombies have happened, but they're zombies, and the party dispatches the zombies. But then they find out later that more people have mysteriously gone missing, and those people then are seen the next day or 24 hours later as zombies, right? So you create a little mystery. You don't reveal that this is a white who's causing all this to happen yet until the encounter. Now the party encounters the white with the white's zombie minions, and maybe finds out that, you know, this white has the mark of Orcus on it. They do some research, some investigation, some arcana. They find out that this white made this pact with Orcus. And they start to connect these story threads. And that's where, at mid-level or high level, you can tie in the Bodex or the Hierophants of Annihilation, these, you know, more dire and insidious Bodex with great magical power. Or maybe even mortal cultists, like, you know, clerics and wizards who kind of use necromancy to take advantage of the connection to the undead. Or maybe, you know, who have summoned demons, lesser demons, to be involved. So I think the white is great as a drop-in for an adventure where, you know, lower to mid-level parties have to figure out why people are going missing, why they're returning as zombies. You could scale them up by adding multiple whites. You can really scale them up to high level by buffing all of their stats and making them more damage resistant, giving them more hit points, making the saves against their life drain higher, make the life drain do more damage. Lots of different options there. One of the biggest things, though, is that that life drain can't be healed without a long rest. I think that's a crucial thing. And especially at mid to higher level, you could really make that a challenging situation if the party can't get a long rest. What if their long rests keep getting interrupted by these attacks from the undead? So, you know, I think that's where you can kind of make this more challenging logistically for the party and make it not just about combat, but about figuring out a way to, you know, basically hole up long enough to get a long rest to heal. So the white is a pretty common creature. And obviously, if you're used to running games where undead are featured, you've probably used a white before. But hopefully this has been informative, or maybe just stimulated some of your thinking about how to tie the white into a larger campaign. So please, if you have any experiences using whites or encountering them as players, share in the comments below. And as always, thank you guys for subscribing and supporting the channel. We'll see you on the next one.